Hi everyone, do you want to create visuals that not only look great but also communicate your KPIs effectively? Then this video is for you. In this video, I'll show you how to transform a basic line chart into an insightful and engaging KPI visual using some of the recently introduced features in Power BI. Let's get started. Let me take you through the step that I have taken to build this KPI card from a native line chart that comes in Power BI. So first thing, in this report, what I have done is I have created this card just to show the revenue first for the selected period. Here I have selected the year as the time period, then some other filters on country and segment. So this is showing the revenue for 2014, which is 0.4 for mid-market and Mexico country. And I'm comparing here the revenue with against the target. It's a positive 2.1%, and also it shows the trending, whether it's trending up or down with an indicator here. Right now you see here the trend line. This is showing as it's trending up slightly. So the indicator is showing correctly as trending up. So this is the title, and the second part is the subtitle, right? And then over here in the plot area, in the line chart, I am highlighting the first month and the last month that is within the selected period. In 2014, we have the first month January and the last month December. In addition to that, I am also showing the minimum sales within this period. The May has the minimum sales, and the maximum sale is in June. So now this is fully interactive. So I don't want to overcrowd this visual, so I have included only whatever is necessary for us to get a better understanding of this particular revenue. I have the comparison, I have the trend. So now, before we get started, let's go and have a look at the data model, what I have used. Basically, I have used the sample data that comes with Power BI, the financials, and I have added a date table to that. Okay, let me go into the financials data table. The only thing I have done to this table is added a target column, because I want to compare my actuals against the target. So what I did, basically added a column with some random numbers based on the sales amount. I multiplied by a random number, which is plus or minus 10% on the sales, and rounding it up to 1000. This is my column, which shows me, gives me the target value. And I have created a table for the dates. It's a simple dates table, right? And then the relationship is there between date and financials. With this, we can now get started with building a KPI card that I have here. Now the first step is to make a copy of this line chart. Let me control C, control V, and place it right here, and I can make it a little bigger. Okay, so it's easy to work with. Now this is a simple line chart. What I have included here in this line chart is just month, year, a month year column for x-axis, and for the y-axis I have the sales amount. Okay, now the first thing is, let's have a look at each element at a time. Okay, now what we have here is the title. Okay, I have applied a dynamic title over here. Then we have the subtitle, that's also dynamic. And the third one is the plot area, the line chart basically. So let's first have a look at the title. Okay, now if you go to the title, right now the title is hard-coded with sales amount by month. So we are going to use a measure to get the title and make it dynamic. So the measure already is being created. Let me show you what's inside. Sales amount title. Here I have used revenue as the title, and used over here an icon from emoji by pressing a Windows key and a period. So you will get multiple options here to choose from. So I have selected here one emoji to represent revenue. If you have a table where you have images, you can also use it instead of emojis. Now then I concatenate the value of the sales amount. It's been formatted to show millions here. That's why I have given commas after zero, and this represent, this is a million. Okay, this is my title. So let me go and apply this dynamic title to the visual title over here. Click on FX and let me get the title. So now I have my title working. Okay, great. Now the second part is the subtitle. Select the visual. Subtitle is turned off. I'm going to turn it on. Instead of hard-coded value here, I'm going to use again another measure to calculate the dynamic title for the subtitle. So now you look at the subtitle over here, there are two parts. First is the target comparison, then the second part is the trend up or down indicator. So I have concatenated these two values. Let's go and have a look at the measure, how it's been built. The name is target sales subtitle. If I expand, so let me take you through this big measure. It's not huge. I have organized it in such a way that I have used variables to make it look simple and easy to work with. And first I grab a target achievement measure and then give it a format for positive and negative and for zero value. This is my string after formatting. Then third variable I just assign two unicodes. This is for the positive and the second one is for the negative. If the achievement is greater than or equal to zero, then I just create this text string where I include this positive sign, the formatted value, and I mention target. Second line is for the negative value. Right, then the second part, if you see in my measure, after the target I have a pipe sign, then the trend up down indicator. When sales trend to calculate, I have used a measure, sales amount slope. This measure actually gives me either positive or negative value based on the trend line. If the trend line is upward, then it's positive. If it's downwards, it's negative. So based on this value, I can decide which icon to show, right? Which sign to show for the trending up or down in my subtitle. So if the sales slope is greater than zero, I show trending up with that sign, otherwise the negative. Then I'm putting it together as a result. Now sales amount slope, how did I calculate that? Let me show you the measure now. Okay. For this I have used one of the latest functions that was introduced in Power BI called LINESTX, so which produces a lot of results. So in this case I am grabbing the slope from this, right? So LINESTX function asks for three inputs. First is the table. I have created a temp table here called month sales, where I'm summarizing the sales by month and year. That is the first one. Then we have the y and the x values. My y is the sales amount, the x is the month and year. So once you provided this, it can give you a table. So in this table I am grabbing the slope one, right? That's the slope. So if you want to see what is produced from this function, I can just copy this measure and go to DAX Studio. Let me paste that measure over here. Evaluate. I have my table. So let me remove this max x so that I can show you the table that is generated. So this is my linest function. I have given the three parameters. If I run this, I have these output. slope, intercept, standard error, slope one, and so on. So from here, what I'm interested is the slope one value. In this case, this is a positive number. Now, if you go back to the measure, so in my measure, what I have done is I have grabbed the slope one value, and that's my result. So with this output, I'm able to now get the value of the trending up or down for me to use in my subtitle. Let me go and assign my subtitle to the visual. Okay, now this is showing the target comparison and also the trending up or down. Yeah, this works perfectly fine. Okay, the third part is the line chart itself, the plot area, where we will have a look at the formatting and the measures that I have used here. So the first thing is, I don't need the X and Y axis. I can turn them off. I can remove the markers and also the data labels. Now, the first part here is, let's have a look at how I have assigned the max and the minimum value to be highlighted, right? So for that, I have also created a measure. Let me show you min month sales. This is a simple measure where I first grab the sales amount in the current context, then I calculate the minimum sales in the months that I have selected. So I have sales in this case January to December, so I am calculating which month has the lowest sales, right, using this minx function. Then I check if the current month is equal to the minimum month sales, then I assign the current month sales, so otherwise it will be blank. Similarly, I have built another measure for the maximum sales. Now I can go and assign these two measures to my chart. Okay, first open this up, and under y-axis I'm going to add the minimum sales and the maximum sales. Fine. Now you see it has highlighted the max and the minimum sales. Okay, so if I change the slicer value here, it should get changed accordingly. Yes, that's working. Now the second part is the first and the last month. So I want to highlight the first month and the last month, in this case January and December. For that, again a measure. This measure is called first and last month sales. Let's have a look at it. What I basically do in this measure is, first I get the current visible month and assign it to a variable, then I calculate the last month using max, then the first month using min over here, then finally the result. I check if the current month is equal to the first or the last month, then I show the sales amount. Okay, now I will go and assign the first and last month measure here. Under y-axis, add data, first and last month measure. Now let's apply some formatting. Now here under lines, let's choose first and last measure. Let me make the lines width to 0, and I can turn on the markers. Markers, I don't need it for the sales amount, I can turn it off. Okay, now let's apply a bit of formatting here. Let's choose all from here so I can apply all at once. The first and last markers, let's make it dark gray. Maximum, let me pick greens. And the minimum, red, and the sales sum online color, let me make it this one. I just need to show the trend line as well, so click on the formatting option here and let's add the trend line. Now what's remaining is to show the label for the first and the last month values. So for that I have also used the latest feature, which is the dynamic format string. So if you go to the measure first and last month, and this is my measure, and you see I have applied a dynamic formatting, right? Instead of the regular one, I have applied dynamic formatting. The formatting is applied over here, and if you go and choose format, so here what happens is I use selected value to get the current month and then apply a formatting to show month and year. So this is to make it a string output. Now the only thing I need to do is turn on the label for this. Now label is shown for all. Let me choose sales amount. I can turn it off. So let me pick the first and last, and I can apply some formatting onto this. Now if you see, the label for maximum and minimum are also visible, but if you want you can hide them. I don't want to add a lot of elements to this, so I will turn it off. And for the max, I can turn it off. With that, I have come to an end, and I have built the visual that I showed you earlier. So if you have any questions or comments, please leave it in the comments below. Thank you very much.